Good evening and welcome. Let's take a look at the top story that we are tracking for you. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi met Pope Francis at the Vatican City. The Pope has also accepted an invitation by the Indian Prime Minister to visit India. This will be the first papal visit to India since 1999. Prime Minister Modi was also one of only three world leaders who met the Pope on the sidelines of the G20 summit. The meeting between the two leaders was crucial, since both are pushing for better climate strategy. While the Pope has given a clarion call for climate, Prime Minister Modi has echoed his sentiments while pushing for sustainable clean energy. Prime Minister Modi gifted the Pope a silver candlestick and a book on the commitment to environment on their maiden meet. In return, Pope Francis gave Prime Minister Modi a bronze plaque with the inscription, "The desert will become a garden." Volumes of papal documents, his message for the World Day of Peace, and the document on human fraternity. Now, the Pope also gave gifts to the Indian contingent that has accompanied the Prime Minister for the meeting.
Il grano, l'uva, e si dice il deserto, traduci tu, il deserto diventerà un giardino.
In the meeting that lasted about an hour, Prime Minister Modi and the Pope discussed over a range of issues of interest. The COVID-19 pandemic and climate crisis topped the agenda. The meet was to be followed by a delegation-level dialogue. Now, the meeting between the two leaders has been hailed by the Roman Catholic community in India. Catholics are the third largest religious community in India.
The Prime Minister invited Pope Francis to visit India at an early date. The last papal visit to India was in 1999 when Pope John Paul II visited India. The Pope has graciously attended the Prime Minister's, accepted the Prime Minister's invitation, and in his own words, I'm paraphrasing him, he says, "You have given me the greatest gift. I'm looking forward to visiting India." This is a private audience that the Prime Minister had with the Pope. The two leaders discussed many topical issues, including the COVID-19 pandemic, economic and health recovery from the pandemic, the issue of climate change and the environment.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi met the Pope here at the Vatican, a significant meeting, and of course we have seen the pictures as well, the leaders meeting with a lot of warmth here at the Vatican. A lot of things in the focus when it comes to the meeting, climate change, poverty, the Indian Prime Minister inviting the Pope to visit India. The last papal visit to India was in 1999 when the Prime Minister was Atal Bihari Vajpayee, but nonetheless this is Vatican is the smallest country both in terms of population and in terms of the size, but it has an outsized influence when it comes to the world, given the Pope stays here and this meeting of course also happening. The Indian Prime Minister of course is the third leader to meet the Pope in last 24 hours. Before him, the US President Joe Biden and the South Korean President Moon Jae-in met, in which the focus was on tackling the COVID crisis, with video journalist Ajit Siddhan Sibyl for Vion at the Vatican.
Prime Minister Modi has become the fifth Indian premier to meet the Pope. Before Modi, four Indian prime ministers had met the previous heads of Vatican in the past. Now, when the unrest in Goa under the Portuguese was high, then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru had met Pope Pius XII in 1955. Now, his daughter and former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi had met Pope John Paul II in 1981. Ex-Prime Minister Inder Kumar Gujral also met Pope John Paul II in 1997. Now, Atal Bihari Vajpayee had met the same Pope in the year 2000. Thus, Modi is now the fifth Indian Prime Minister to meet a pontiff. Now, for more on this story, we are being joined by our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhan Sibyl, from Rome. Good evening to you, Siddhan. Thanks for being with us. Now, Prime Minister Modi one of only three world leaders to meet the Pope on the sidelines of the G20 summit. We know the meeting lasted for about an hour, much longer than expected. Take us through some of the main talking points that were discussed, including climate and COVID recovery.
Well, a significant meeting between the Indian Prime Minister and Pope, who of course holds immense authority when it comes to millions and millions of Christians, Catholics. But largely, if we look at the key outcomes, the fact that Indian Prime Minister has invited was the biggest outcome from this meeting, the Indian Prime Minister inviting Pope to India, and this has been accepted by the Pope, confirmed by the Indian Foreign Secretary Harsh Shringla a short while ago at that presser. But largely, gifts were exchanged, and the meeting, of course, lasted for almost an hour. This is what the sources have been telling us. There were the Indian delegation as well, the NSA, Ajit Doval, the Indian External Affairs Minister, Dr. S. Jaishankar, and Foreign Secretary Harsh Shringla. They were all present in the later delegation meeting as well. But largely, we know that the focus is on how both sides can engage. They conversed on topical issues like COVID crisis, climate change. In fact, the Indian Prime Minister has given the Pope a book on environment. This is something that has been close to the heart of the Indian Prime Minister, who in fact gave the proposal of the International Solar Initiative, Solar Alliance, which was proposed by the Indian Prime Minister in 2015. And since then, it has in fact taken off, and it is now based in India. First international organization like this to be based out of India. And over 100 countries are now part of this important climate initiative. There were in fact questions at the briefing as well. Was any discussion happened on religious freedom, to which the Foreign Secretary replied that there was no such discussion. It was devoid of such issues, but it was rather a special and private meeting between the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and of course the Pope. We have seen the visual of course exude of warmth and of course camaraderie, and of course how both leaders greeted each other at the Vatican today.
Right, Siddhant.
We are now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.